In this video, we will understand how content from app.component.html got included into the app root tag. Once Angular finds app root custom element in index.html, it looks into app.module.ts in src app folder. In app.module.ts, it looks into the declaration section and finds app component. Let us go back to our architecture diagram and include app.module.ts. We will include an arrow to denote that it looks in the declaration section and picks app component. Coming back to Visual Studio Code, let us find out what is app component from the imports. In line number 5, we can see the import from app component. It is imported from the file named app.component in the current folder. This actually represents the app.component.ts file present in the same folder. Let me go back to the diagram and include that control flow from app.module.ts to app.component.ts. Now, coming back to Visual Studio Code, let us look into the contents of app.component.ts. In line number 4, we can see the selector defined as app root. Let us go back to the diagram and include the selector as app root. Now we can see that this matches with the custom element included in index.html. Now going back to Visual Studio Code. As the selector value matches with the custom element, it then looks into the value of template URL. We can see the template URL value is defined as app.component.html. We already know this file which is present in the same folder. This is the file we modified to include the h1 tag. Now let me go back to the diagram to explain. Let me first include the template URL in app.component.ts, which points to app.component.html. Now the HTML content within app.component.html is retrieved and included between the app root tag in index.html. All of these operations mentioned in this video is controlled and managed by Angular internally. Hope this gives an explanation on how app.component.html got included within app root tag in index.html. This explanation so far given in this video gives the answer for the second question. But unfortunately, we have ended up having even more questions than what we had earlier. Let me try to list out those questions. What are these files app.module.ts and app.component.ts? What does the files with extension ts mean? What is the importance of app.module.ts and what does the content within app.module.ts mean? What is the importance of app.component.ts and what does the content within app.component.ts mean? What is the importance of the keywords import, export, and class? And finally, what is this syntax starting with @? We will get answers for these questions in the subsequent videos.